Okay, hello, and let me introduce you to the Leclerc EVOLUTION. So the Leclerc EVOLUTION is the KNDS France proposal for tomorrow's tank, which is basically built around the experience that has been acquired by KNDS with the Leclerc tank and with the EMBT turret that was exhibited 2 years ago. The main differences with the Leclerc lie first in the turret. You can see that the turret silhouette is very narrow, very thin, to allow for a good survivability of the silhouette of the tank. The main gun has been modified, so we are not with the usual 120mm gun from the Leclerc, but we are using our new concept, which is the Ascalon weapon in its 120mm caliber. The turret also exhibits a loitering ammunition pod, which is able to host three loitering ammunitions, which have an endurance of about 1 hour, which allow the crew to operate from a distance with the the enemy. You can also see on the back of the turret that there's an ARX 30, which is a 30mm remote operated weapon station, which is here to allow the self-protection of the tank, but also to ensure that the UAV threat is treated. So this turret is manned, so there are two operators in the turret, the tank commander and the gunner. But as there are a lot more sensors and effectors than on the Leclerc, namely local situational awareness system, a laser warning system, APS, etc., we believe that the tank commander's cognitive load is likely to be very high and almost unmanageable. So that's why we believe, by adding a fourth crew member, the deputy commander, inside the tank in the chassis besides the driver, we can put this deputy commander in charge of all these systems so that they are pre-treated for the account of the tank commander, allowing him to concentrate on its tactical tasks. The chassis is based on the Leclerc chassis. It therefore hosts two operators, and its protection has been reinforced both on the sides and on the front. So, as I said, one of the main differences with the Leclerc turret is the Ascalon gun. So the Ascalon weapon concept has been introduced 2 years ago at EUROSATORY 2022, and it's now showcased in its two different caliber versions, 120mm and 140mm. The 120mm uses the exact same ammunition as the standard 120mm tank gun, but the 140mm provides a very, very more important performance with 40 to 70% more penetration on the target. This with still a weapon which is very compact, which weighs slightly more than the 120mm gun, but which provides the same recoil force than the 120mm gun. This 140mm gun has been already tested by KNDS France and is now integrated into the EMBT ADT turret, so the Ascalon demonstrator turret, which is here to illustrate what KNDS France anticipates as the future European concept for the main ground combat system. This turret is going to be firing on the move as early as next year with a remotely operated turret, which means that there will be no one in the turret.